In this video, we are going to discuss beta function part 3. Now, learning outcome. At the end of this session, students will be able to evaluate definite integrals by beta function. Now, in this video, we are going to discuss beta function as improper integral, and it is defined as beta of mn is equal to integration from 0 to infinity x raised to m minus 1 divided by 1 plus x raised to m plus n dx. And now we'll see how we'll get this formula. This is a third form of beta function. We already seen the two different forms of beta function. Now let x is equal to tan square theta, then you get dx is equal to 2 tan theta sec square theta d theta. Now accordingly, we can change the limit when x is equal to 0 means tan square theta equal to 0 means theta equal to 0, and when x tends to infinity we get theta equal to pi by 2. Therefore, we can write integration from 0 to infinity x raised to m minus 1 divided by 1 plus x raised to m plus n dx is equal to integration from 0 to pi by 2. Now putting x equal to tan square theta, we will write tan square theta raised to m minus 1 divided by 1 plus tan square theta raised to m plus n, and the value of dx is 2 tan theta sec square theta d theta. Now which is equal to taking 2 outside, that is twice 0 to pi by 2, that is tan square theta raised to m minus 1 into tan theta can be written as tan theta raised to 2m minus 1 into sec square theta d theta divided by 1 plus tan square theta is sec square theta. We can write sec square theta raised to m plus n, which is equal to twice integration from 0 to pi by 2. Now tan theta raised to 2m minus 1 as it is, that is tan theta raised to 2m minus 1 and sec square theta raised to m plus n and sec square theta. We can write sec theta raised to 2m plus 2n minus 2 d theta. Therefore, integration from 0 to infinity x raised to m minus 1 upon 1 plus x raised to m plus n dx is equal to twice. Now writing tan in terms of sine and cosine, you get twice 0 to pi by 2 sine theta raised to 2m minus 1 upon cos theta raised to 2m minus 1 into cos theta raised to 2m plus 2n minus 2 d theta, that is 1 by sec theta means cos theta, which is equal to, you can write twice 0 to pi by 2 sin theta raised to 2m minus 1, and simplify these two, we get cos theta raised to 2n minus 1 d theta, which is the trigonometric form of beta function or second form of beta function, which is equal to, we can write beta of mn. Therefore, beta of mn equal to, we can write integration from 0 to infinity x raised to m minus 1 upon 1 plus x raised to m plus n dx. Now we'll see the example. Evaluate the integral integration from 0 to infinity x raised to 6 into bracket 1 minus x raised to 10 bracket complete whole divided by 1 plus x raised to 24 dx. Now we can write integration from 0 to infinity x raised to 6 into bracket 1 minus x raised to 10 divided by 1 plus x raised to 24 dx is equal to, you know, here multiplying x raised to 6 inside, we get integration from 0 to infinity x raised to 6 divided by 1 plus x raised to 24 dx minus, that is x raised to 6 into x raised to 10, that is x raised to 16 divided by 1 plus x raised to 24 dx. Now these two integrals are in the form of integration from 0 to infinity x raised to m minus 1 divided by 1 plus x raised to m plus n. Now here m minus 1 is 6, which you can write, first integral can be written as, which is equal to integration from 0 to infinity x raised to 6, we can write x raised to 7 minus 1. That is here m is 7 and m plus n is 24, therefore we get n as 17, that we can write 1 plus x raised to 7 plus 17, that is m plus n, here m is 7 and n is 17 and m plus n is 24 minus integration from 0 to infinity. Similarly, here x raised to 16 divided by 1 plus x raised to 24 can be written as x raised to 17 minus 1. Here m is x raised to 16 can be written as x raised to 17 minus 1. That is, here m is 17 and m plus n is 24. Therefore, n is 17. Therefore, we can write x raised to 17 minus 1 divided by 1 plus x raised to 17 plus 7 dx, which is equal to, we have beta of 7, 17 minus beta of 17, 7 by using the definition of beta function, that is as a improper beta function as a improper integral, which is equal to 0 because your beta of mn is equal to beta of nm. Now pause the video for a while and evaluate integration from 0 to infinity x raised to 8 divided by 1 plus x raised to 24 dx. I hope you have completed. Now see here, we can write integration from 0 to infinity x raised to 8 divided by 1 plus x raised to 24 dx is equal to, we can write integration from 0 to infinity x raised to 8 can be written as x raised to 9 minus 1 divided by 1 plus x raised to 9 plus 15 dx. Since here m is equal to 9 and m plus n is equal to 24, therefore what we get, n is equal to 15. Now which is in the form of integration from 0 to infinity x raised to m minus 1 divided by 1 plus x raised to m plus n, and which is equal to, we can write beta of mn, that is beta of 9, 15. Now using the relation between beta and gamma function, we can write which is equal to gamma of 9 into gamma of 15 divided by gamma of 9 plus 15. Now gamma of 9 can be written as 8 factorial, gamma of 15 can be written as 14 factorial, and gamma of 24 can be written as 23 factorial by using the property of gamma function. This is what the value of the given integral. Now we'll see one more example. Prove that integration from 0 to infinity root x divided by 4 plus 4x plus x square dx is equal to pi by 2 root 2. Now consider the given example, integration from 0 to infinity root x divided by 4 plus 4x plus x square dx. Now which can be written as, which is equal to integration from 0 to infinity x raised to 1 by 2, and this 4 plus 4x plus x square can be written as 2 plus x whole square dx. And now we have to express this in terms of beta function as an improper integral, and for that we can make use of the substitution x is equal to 2t, therefore dx equal to 2dt. Accordingly, here we have to change the limits. When x is equal to 0, we get the value of t as a 0. And when x tends to infinity, here t also tends to infinity. Therefore, the given integral I, we can write I equal to integration from 0 to infinity. Now here putting x equal to 2t, that is 2t raised to 1 by 2 divided by 2 plus 2t whole square, and the value of dx as a 2dt, which is equal to 2 raised to half into 2 means 2 root 2. And here you taking 2 common, that is 2 square means what we get, 4, into integration from 0 to infinity, we get t raised to 1 by 2 divided by 1 plus t whole square dt. Now which is in the form of beta function. Therefore the given integral can be written as 1 by root 2 integration from 0 to infinity t raised to 1 by 2 can be written as t raised to 3 by 2 minus 1 divided by 1 plus t raised to 3 by 2 plus 1 by 2 dt. Since here we know m minus 1 is 1 by 2, therefore value of m is 3 by 2. And also here we have m plus n is 2, means here we have n is equal to 2 minus m, that is 2 minus 3 by 2, which is equal to 1 by 2. That is, here we have written the given integral as 1 by root 2 integration from 0 to infinity m minus 1 means 3 by 2 minus 1 divided by 1 plus t raised to m plus n, that is 3 by 2 plus 1 by 2, means here m is 3 by 2 and n is 1 by 2. Therefore, we can write which is equal to 1 by root 2 beta of m means 3 by 2 and n means 1 by 2. Now, which is equal to, here using the relation between beta and gamma function, we can write beta of 3 by 2 and 1 by 2 as which is equal to 1 by root 2 gamma of 3 by 2 into gamma of 1 by 2 divided by gamma of 3 by 2 plus 1 by 2, which is equal to 1 by root 2, and gamma of 3 by 2 can be written as 1 by 2 into gamma of 1 by 2, keeping gamma of 1 by 2 as it is, and gamma of 3 by 2 plus 1 by 2 is gamma of 2. Now, which is equal to, by simplifying this, you get 1 by 2 root 2, and gamma of 1 by 2 whole square, and gamma of 2, we can write 1 factorial, which is equal to 1 by 2 root 2, and we know the gamma of value of gamma of 1 by 2 is root pi, that is root pi whole square, and gamma of 1 factorial is 1, and which is equal to, we can write pi by 2 root 2, hence the proof. References: Higher Engineering Mathematics by Dr. B.S. Grewal, 2018.